Some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place, but I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. My eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Amen, amen. Welcome to the MLK Scholarship Service. Amen. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. Can we just celebrate on today? Amen, amen, amen. At this time, we welcome you to our service and our celebration. And we're going to have our president, the Honorable Reverend William D. McCullough, come before us with greetings to you.
Put those hands together, give God some praise. Come on, y'all can do better than that. I didn't say give McCullough no praise. Come on, let's give God some praise. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we ought to rejoice and be glad. Hallelujah. He woke you up this morning, started you on your way, and you ought to just clap those hands for Jesus. Come on, you ought to pat your feet. Come on, you ought to wave your hand and tell God thank you. Come on, he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. You may be seated in his presence. Man, we bring you greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. On behalf of the Interdenominational Ministerial Alliance of Bridgeport and vicinity, we welcome you to our annual MLK worship service, worship scholarship service, amen, because this is in honor of scholarships, amen, where we help, all of our children who are graduating go to college, amen, and we don't do nothing but give them $500, amen. Last year we gave 17 kids $500, amen, and they were able to pay for at least a book or two. Somebody say amen. And so today, amen, we come because Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, he was real strong about education, graduated from Morehouse, amen, went on down to Chester, Pennsylvania, graduated from Crozier Theological Seminary, amen, went on up, hallelujah, to Massachusetts, just was a, just an advocate for education, believed in education. Somebody say amen. So we come to remember a man who loved God, all right, and who fought for justice, amen, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., amen. So we thank you for coming, amen. We thank you for being a part of this service, amen, and we pray that you will have an experience like none before, amen. Don't sit back, don't relax, amen. I don't want you to kick your shoes off either, amen, but I want you to get on the edge of your seat, amen, as we celebrate, man, the life of a legacy, as we commemorate somebody who stood up for what was right, amen, and had a dream, amen, and now we're seeing that thing come to pass. I know we still got a long ways to go, amen, but if you do your part, amen, if you get up every morning and do your part, amen, we'll get there, amen, like he said we would. Somebody say amen. There's another greetings, amen, from our state congressman, amen, Jim Himes. We're going to hear from him, amen. He brought us greetings, and we thought it not robbery to hear from him, and we'll hear from him at this time. Congressman Jim Himes. Come on, put your hands together.
Hi, everyone. It's Congressman Jim Himes, and I'm delighted to offer some greetings on this Martin Luther King Day. Every year when this holiday rolls around, I'm reminded afresh of what a remarkable soul Martin Luther King was. He obviously, probably more than anybody in American history, moved to address the original sin of the United States, the enslavement of people and the Jim Crow and all of the discrimination and bigotry that was visited on African Americans and to some extent continues to be visited today. He was a remarkable leader in that regard, but his remit and his interest was much broader than that. People will know that he was ultimately assassinated when he was in Memphis, Tennessee, standing up and rallying for sanitation workers who were disenfranchised, treated very badly, most of whom were white. He was a voice against the Vietnam War, and he was a voice, most importantly, for nonviolence, for centering love when we make societal change. And I think particularly at this polarized time, where we still have the kinds of problems that Martin Luther King gave his life to address, we'd all be well advised to remember his attitude, his philosophy, his idea of change rooted in love and nonviolence. So on this day on, not a day off, I encourage you to bask as I do in that legacy and to think about what you as well as all of us can do to advance his cause.
Amen. We thank our presidents for his greetings. We thank Congressman Jim Hines for his greetings. Amen. And we're going to move right along with the service. Amen. We are excited about being able to come together and fellowship and share love and express our joy. Amen. The fight is not over and the struggle is still real. Amen. And at this time, for the order of the service, we're going to have in this order our opening prayer by Elder Teresa Webb. We're going to have the reading of the scripture by Pastor Marjo Anderson, and after which we're going to ask you to stand and join in with us lifting our voice under the direction of Simone Brown and the Brown family, of Evangelist Simone Brown. Amen. And we want to celebrate in that order. And would you come?
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Let us bow our heads in prayer, please. Father God, we thank you for this day that you have made, and let us be glad and rejoice in it. We thank you for your love and your kindness and your grace and your mercy that is renewed each and every day. We thank you, God, for allowing us to have the opportunity to remember Martin Luther King Jr., who dreamed of loving just society for all, honoring him today by taking a time to stop and reflect on his leadership. Gracious God, we live in times of deep depression and division and mistrust and violence. Bless in a special way our celebration of this Martin Luther King Day. Open our hearts and minds to your truth and renew our commitment to justice and peace. Pursue us through cooperation and love. Fill us with your Holy Spirit that we might realize and accept that we are all members of the same human family, created in your image and likeness. May the example of Dr. Martin Luther King inspire us to see one another, sisters and brothers with common origin and destiny, guided by the conviction that together we can nobly fulfill the promise of your nation. We pray in the name of God, who is our creator, who calls us to create communities of justice, freedom, and peace. Let us go in peace. Let us go in victory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Praise God, everybody. Praise the Lord. Oh, it is a glorious day. Isn't it good to be here? God has brought us this far along the way. And I have to tell you that I am so grateful to God for bringing me along this far in my journey. And I'm so grateful to be part of the IMA. So grateful that they have received me. I am just so honored to be here with you today and to bring you God's word. This has been an interesting day because we had all kinds of people lined up, and sickness and travel and everything have gotten in the way, but God's Spirit has a way of just raising up whoever is needed at the right time. And so we look forward today to our preacher, the Reverend Dr. Charlie Stallworth, and he is going to be fabulous, because he has a heart for the Lord, and he will preach God's word with power and authority, and we will all be moved. He's going to preach, he told me, from Genesis to Revelation. But he has to be out of here to get to someplace else by noon, so it won't take a whole lot of time. But he'll take us through the scriptures, and the scripture he's going to share, concentrate, focus on is this one. And it's one of my favorites. It's the one from Genesis 50, chapter 20. But before we get there, I'm just going to read to you what goes before. So I'll start with verse 13. When Joseph's brothers saw that their father was dead, they said, "What if Joseph holds a grudge against us and pays us back for all the wrongs we did to him?" So they sent word to Joseph saying, "Your father left these instructions before he died. This is what you are to say to Joseph. I ask you to forgive your brothers the sins and the wrongs they committed in treating you so badly. Now please forgive the sins of the servants of the God of your father." When their message came to him, Joseph wept. His brothers then came and threw themselves down before him. "We are your slaves," they said. But Joseph said to them, "Don't be afraid. Am I in the place of God? You intended to harm me, but God intended it for good, to accomplish what is now being done, the saving of many lives. So then, don't be afraid. I will provide for you and your children." And he reassured them and spoke kindly to them. "You intended to harm me, but God intended it for good. Praise the Lord." Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's give all glory to God. And this morning, amen, it is indeed a blessed day. And we came to celebrate the life of Dr. Martin Luther King, as well as to raise love offerings for those that are in need for school. Amen. But I'm going to ask everyone to please stand as we sing the Black National Anthem at this time. If you would join in with me. Amen.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound.
pieces are God where we met thee. Lest our hearts drunk with the wine of the world we forget thee. Shadow beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God, true to our name.
Amen, amen, amen. May we forever stand. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's celebrate our evangelist Simone. Amen. She never fails to bless us. At this time, we're going to do something just a little bit differently than when we would normally do it. Amen. We're going to have worship in giving. This is a scholarship service where we're raising funds to bless the students of our community, amen? And this is an opportunity where we have a chance to do that. We're asking each IMA member for a $50 gift offering. And those who would like to follow, you're certainly welcome to do the same. And if you're feeling especially generous, you can certainly do more as well. Amen. But at this time, we would like to offer everyone, those who are watching live stream, amen, you're able to do so by Cash App, or in-house, you're able to do so by Cash App. And the IMA Cash App is $IMABPT21. Amen. And you can certainly make your donations to our Cash App. Those monies that are being raised are going directly to the students. Amen. Hallelujah. Again, that Cash App is $IMABPT21. And at this time, we're going to ask Brother Reverend Greenland and our Pastor Godbolt to come, amen, that we might raise those funds in house. Again, $IMABPT21. You are now in the hands of our ushers. Our Pastor Galbolt will be standing for the preacher in the person of our Dr. C. Stallworth, amen. And our Reverend Greenland is going to be standing for the scholarship fund. You're welcome to come at this time. Thank you. Father God, in the sovereign name of your Son, Jesus Christ. God, we honor you. We bless you. God, for the generosity of your people. Lord, those who love to be a blessing to others, we ask now, God, that you would bless them. Lord, let not what they have given even be missed by what they shall receive. And God, we thank you for increase, and we ask also that you would multiply. Bless those who are in the viewing audience that are not in-house. Bless them for their generosity. And God, we thank you now for all things. In Jesus' sovereign name, amen. Amen. God bless you. Thank you once again for your generosity. Amen. And we just want to continue on with our service. Amen. And we thank God for all of the elected officials, all the city council representatives that are here. Amen. Amen. We don't want to call names, but we want to thank God for you for joining us and celebrating with us. Amen. And at this time, we're getting ready for one of the best parts of the service. Amen. And we know that there is a blessing that is in store for us. And as our President McCullough comes to present the speaker to some and introduce to others, we ask that you sit prayerfully and attentively and be blessed by the word. Amen. God bless.
Come on, put those hands together one more time for Jesus, man. Our preacher, I don't want to call him a ram in the bush, amen, but man, he was ready and available, amen, when our first preacher got sick, amen. He is no stranger to this city, man. He is a renowned preacher, amen. He's a sought-after preacher, amen. He's the pastor of the East End Tabernacle Baptist Church right here on the East End of Bridgeport, man, where he served, I think, at least 15 years, maybe more than that. 17 years, I was going to say that, amen. Come on, give God some praise. 17 years, amen. He served 6 terms as a state representative, amen, for the 129th district, amen. So we thank God for that, man. He is no stranger, and I'm going to tell you, he's a learned man, he's a studied man, and he has a burning to go with that yearning. So I want to introduce to some and present to others the Reverend Dr. Charlie Stallworth, pastor of the East End Tabernacle Baptist Church, all the way from East End, Bridgeport, Connecticut. He's our preacher for today. Come on, give God some praise. Hallelujah. So after we hear one more song, is that all right? Hallelujah. From Evangelist Simone, the next voice you will be hearing will be that of, hallelujah, the Reverend Dr. Charlie Stallworth, our preacher.
Amen. There is power in the name of Jesus. And I can hear the chains falling already, because we are ready to do the work that God has set up for us to do. And I ask that you help me on today as we sing this song. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will break every chain. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There's an army rising up. Do I have my army out here? There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Oh, there's an army rising up. There is power in the name of our God Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Oh, to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Oh, to break every chain, break every chain, break all of the chains. Yeah, to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Thank God for the power to break every chain. Each time I hear someone with such a blessed voice to sing like this, it becomes a whole new reality why God did not give me that gift. If God did, I would be singing like 15 songs every Sunday. I want you to take a moment to celebrate with me the leadership of our president, the Reverend William McCullough. Celebrate. Yes. During my time in Bridgeport, he has led the IMA to a level beyond that which we have not experienced. So I want to thank you, Mr. President, for your leadership and for your determination and task. I was in a meeting a couple months ago, I looked at the financial report and I said, we'll raise more money this month than we raised in my whole tenure. So I want to celebrate God for him and for his leadership and for his entire staff and their leadership. As ram in the bush, second batter up, I don't know, but I know my phone rang at 7:30 this morning. And I started not to answer it, but I've been praying to God that somebody would just call me and just give me $1 million. I mean, just call me, just give me $1 million. And so this morning when I saw Pastor Barnes on the call ID, I said, well, this might be my $1 million. Well, I'm still waiting on $1 million, but I thank God for her call. And thank you for the opportunity to stand in. Pray with me. Eternal God, we thank you. We bless you. We praise you. And we celebrate you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. I also honor my colleagues and also, Mr. President, we want to meeting called the other day and my Cash App was having, I'd used it and it looked like a false charge, so my Cash App, but here's my $100 for the venue site that I could not give the other day because I couldn't make my Cash App work. Okay, but I wanted to make sure. All right. In the moments we have before us and as we celebrate the life of Dr. King, I want to label these remarks as authentic celebration. Authentic celebration. Because somewhere between Genesis 37 and Genesis 50, a great transformation takes place. So somewhere between Genesis 37 in which the dreamer is introduced in an attempt at being destroyed, what happened within the first couple of chapters. And then in Genesis 50, where his brothers now show up and try to make some sort of attempt of worship, the scripture that was read, so they fall before him. It's somewhere between Genesis 37 and Genesis 50, in which there is an attempt at celebration, but it's not authentic. The more I celebrate and come upon King Days, and the more I look at the experience from corporate America and political America and other aspects, it's confusing to me. Because what we do on this day is not what we implement on tomorrow. Sometimes I think we act as if King grew old and retired and moved south. Sometimes we act as if he just developed an illness and passed. Sometimes we act as if he succumbed to COVID. We don't recognize what killed him. That it was the very fiber and existence of this country that produced something. So I want to argue today to make sure we don't come in and celebrate the life of a man on Monday and not implement his principles on Tuesday. To make sure we do our best to embrace an authentic celebration. One that's not just in marches and parades and speeches and poems and quotes, but one that will help other people as we go through the week to have an authentic celebration. That's what you find in this text. And there are several things that are important, I believe, to have an authentic celebration. First thing that's important is that there must be a repentance of power. A repentance of power. Church folk, we're good at talking about repentance of sin. But a repentance of sin would not always get you health care. A repentance of sin would not always get you a job. The repentance of sin would not always get you a seat at the table. But there has to be a repentance of power. Let me see if I can make it live. The Constitutional Convention, in which those in power were trying to figure out how this government would be established, never thought to deal deeply with the issue of racism. So they just cloaked it and covered it up. And then that same racism got introduced into the fiber of our very existence. So people would tell you today, I'm not a racist. People will tell you today, I was not back there then. People will tell you today, I was not part of that. Yeah, but you are still reaping the benefits of those who were racist. You are still reaping the benefits of that corporate system. So in order to have a change, there must be a repentance of power, which means legislation, and profit must now be at the benefit of those who have suffered so long. It's only in this country. If you have cheap crack, cocaine, you get a lot of time. But if you got the good stuff, you get less time. It is only in this country, if you get abused by officers who are not just, or you made the person who's the bad person, because they go and dig up your history. They go and dig up what you have done wrong at some point. That must be a repentance of power. That means those who are in office, those who are practicing, must be able to write legislation that's good for our people. That must be a repentance of power. Joseph said to his brothers, you got to go deal with your daddy. You've been faking this thing like you've been grieving. You ain't been grieving. You're the one who put me in the pit. You're the one who sold me into slavery. So I'm not going to let you just go back and talk to your daddy like you didn't do anything. No, you got to go back to the drawing board and deal with your daddy all over again. There must be a repentance of power. But not only must there be a repentance of power, that must be a reinstatement of position. Reinstatement of position. Don't act like you don't owe me something. No. I know. Restitution has become a bad term, so I decided not to use it. I'm going to use reinstatement. Don't act like you don't owe me something. Because my people have invested in this country. We are not asking for a handout. We are asking for our proper due based on the investment we have already made. It's a reinstatement of position. Because, you know, at one point there was the talk about the Back to Africa movement, and then some of the I can't even call his name. Start with a T, though, I think. But it's just a senior moment. And he talked about how, you know, you can leave this country. Well, I was born in Alabama. I'll leave the party. But I'm going to let you know, when I leave, all the liquor I brought, I'm taking it with me. When I leave, all the food I brought, all the food I brought, I'm taking it with me. All the music I brought, I'm taking it with me. Oh, I'll leave if you want me to leave, but everything I have invested, everything I have made, I'm taking all this stuff with me. Joseph says to them, I'm your brother. That's my position. I'm not trying to become your brother. I'm not trying to get in a spot. You just got to reinstate me to where I ought to be already. Right. But finally, I'm done. It must be repentance of power, a reinstatement of position. But finally, there needs to be a reminder of renewal. A reminder of renewal. Somebody else can do the repentance of power. Somebody else can do the reinstatement of position. But no one else can do for you the reminder of renewal. Which means you got to be able to look yourself in the face and remind yourself of that which renews you. Because those who have oppressed you are not overnight going to be the ones who are confirmed you. But you got to be able to look yourself in the face. And while looking yourself in the face, you got to remind yourself of who you are. You got to remind yourself of this divine drama that's going on in the background. Here's what Joseph said. You meant it for evil. But God meant it for good. You took everything you could do to break me, but in your breaking me, you didn't know you were making me. In your you did everything to oppress me, but in your oppressing me, you didn't know how I could take that and turn it into liberation. Oh, I'm done. But you remember that preacher who would go to the slave quarters and he would say, y'all just slaves, y'all nobody. God has created you for this, but something within the mind of the slave took those words and reminded them of renewal. And they said, no, I'm not the N-word, but I'm one of God's children. That's what they said. And they looked at one another in their despair and said, you got shoes and I got shoes and all of God's children got shoes. And when we get to heaven, we're going to put on our shoes and shout all around God's kingdom. Those who oppress. So Dr. King spoke to them that you got to be able to look yourself in the face and remind yourself of all that God has done to renew you along the way. I was in Birmingham last week, and I sat in the 16th Street Baptist Church. All of us will remember when those young lives, girls who was in Sunday school were taken. And I thought, while sitting there, what must the people have felt at that moment when that bomb shook the whole sanctuary? And I kept thinking about that over and over again. But something deep down within, as if my ancestors were speaking from the past. Says Stallworth, if you become depressed and overcome with that, you will miss the worship of this moment in the sanctuary. You got to remind yourself of what God has done for you. Don't forget what others have done against you, but remind yourself of what God has done for you, that you can look out to the world and say, you meant it for evil, but God was working it out, but God was making a way, but God was picking me up, but God was establishing my ways. Oh yeah, I can celebrate, but my celebration must be authentic, because I can't celebrate today and go out and cut jobs tomorrow. I can't celebrate today and refuse people health care tomorrow. But what happens on Monday, I gotta make it live on Tuesday. God bless you.
Amen, amen, amen. What was meant to be evil, God made it turn out for my good. Thank God for repentance of power, the reinstatement of position, and the reminder of renewal. Can we bless God for that word? Hallelujah, Jesus. A timely word for such a time as this. Amen. Furthering the message of the man we call Martin Luther King Jr. And at this time, we're going to move right along. Amen. To honor your time, we're going to have a video presentation from some of the recipients of the scholarships that have been awarded. Amen. And after that, we're going to call on the chairperson of the scholarship committee, our Father Christopher Layton, to come and to share with you the purpose of why we do this. Amen. The video presentation.
Hi, my name is Joshua, and I just want to say how appreciative and grateful I am for the IMA scholarship that I received my freshman year of college. During that time period, it was a really, really hectic adjustment. It was really hard for me to adjust to a schedule and figure out what I was doing. I didn't even have a major picked out at that point yet. And the IMA scholarship really relieved some financial burdens during that time. It allowed me to not have to focus so much on working, having that little bit of extra money to put towards my expenses, things like supplies and books and whatever that I normally would have had to work for. It just gave me a little bit more time and headspace and peace, and it was a huge blessing for me during that time. So I just want to say how grateful I am and how much I really appreciate the IMA. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ari, and I wanted to thank the IMA for the scholarship that I received. For my freshman year of college, I wanted to be at a university that was the farthest away from home that I'd ever be staying, and to help with that transition, I wanted to bring my cat with me as a registered emotional support animal to kind of help cope with that transition. However, finding a roommate to stay with me and the cat really wasn't easy, and single housing is more expensive, but that ended up being my only option. So the funds really made it so that I was able to have my cat with me for support and, you know, be able to be so far away from home, out of state, by myself. So a huge thank you to the IMA for making that possible.
Hi, my name is Tyrone, and I would like to say thank you to the IMA for blessing me with the scholarship gift this year. Being able to go into school with the scholarship can make a huge difference, and it did in my case, as I was able to have a completely different experience from my peers. Something as small as owning your own books is a big deal in college, especially when you're trying to figure yourself out. For me, being able to take notes in my books directly in the notebook, not worrying about taking it back in pristine condition, was big for me, because when I would go back and study, I wouldn't be like my peers flipping through several notebooks just to find a few notes to make sense of a small article. It was all right there for me. So again, I would like to say thank you, thank you, thank you.
Hello, my name is Cherie Wright, and I would like to say thank you to the IMA for granting me the scholarship back in 2019. Before I went off to college, it definitely helped me with expenses and gave me that extra cushion that I needed before I went off to college. So far, college has been a whirlwind of experiences, and I'm in nursing school right now, so I'm on my way to getting my BSN RN. But just thank you so much for giving me that scholarship and believing in me and granting me with that money so that I would be able to cover my expenses, get my books, and just jumpstart my big journey in college. Thank you so much, and God bless.
Thank you, Lord. Jesus said, "Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are those who have been persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you and persecute you and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me." Because of me, the Lord says. "Rejoice and be glad, for your reward in heaven is great." The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., oh, he was a civil rights activist. He was an agent for political change. But what we have to emphasize about his legacy is he is a Christian, As my mother would say, a real Christian. Do you know a real Christian? You know what we mean by that? He walked the talk. An ordained minister. He said, "Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? What are you doing for others? What are you doing for others? What can you do today to help our graduating seniors go to college? Many of you came forward and already made a donation. And on behalf of the IMA and the Scholarship Committee, I want to thank you for your consideration and your gift. And as we heard our president say, we gave 17 scholarships in 2022, $500 each. That's a lot. It's good. We're grateful. But I am not satisfied. There's a famous moment in my family around the dinner table where my daughter was proud of the fact that she didn't have to work to get a B in a subject. A B. And she could do a lot better than a B. And I said, "Are you satisfied? Are you satisfied?" It became lore that my kids still remember. I'm not satisfied with 17. How many people graduated from high school in Bridgeport and went on to college? A lot more than 17. How many people needed help? A lot more than 17. So I want you to consider in the coming year what else you can do on behalf of the Lord Jesus Christ, on behalf of these students who are completing high school. Some of them are going
to college as the first member of their family ever going to college. We can do more. In remembrance of Dr. King and for the improvement of life of others, I ask you to consider keep on giving towards the scholarship fund. 100% of it goes right to the students. There's no overhead. There's no cost. It's free from us to them. So I ask for the Lord to bless you and keep you this day. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your support of our students. I'm so proud to be in Bridgeport. I got to preach to those students last summer as they received their gifts. They were proud of their achievement and of their worthiness to receive those scholarships. Let's do it again, and let's do it even better in 2023.
Thank you, Christopher Layden. Thank you so much. Come on, give God some praise. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, man. Thank y'all so much. We were able to raise about $1,700 today, man. If we could get that to $2,000, it would be wonderful. Hallelujah. That's four scholarships. Amen. If we could get that to $2,000, our Cash App is $IMABPT21. $IMABPT21. Somebody say amen. I know somebody out there got another $200-$300, amen, and if you want to do something with it, amen, this is your opportunity to share, amen, and to bless one of those young children's lives, amen, on their way to college, amen. Hallelujah. We're about to come to an end of our service, amen. We all heard earlier, amen, where Ernie Newton, he left. I just want to shout out to Ernie Newton. He come to all of our services, amen. Y'all let him know that I shouted out to him when you see him, amen. He's our city councilman, man, over here on the East End. He's been serving a long time. He was once a senator, amen, and so we thank God for his diligent service, amen, and commitment, amen, to the city of Bridgeport. Our mayor is here. Joe Gallum is here, amen. We heard from our congressman today, Jim Himes. He sent a video, but our mayor is here in person. He was a little late, amen. I want to give you a chance to bring greetings, amen, on behalf of the IMA. You can stand there if you want, or you can come up here if you want to, amen. Come on, y'all can do better than that. He's still our mayor, amen. How much we giving?
Okay. Let me I just ask that pastor. I just want to say praise to God. And my microphone's not on.
Thank you and praise to God. Just briefly, it's my pleasure and honor to join you in many earlier services this morning, where I was both woken up and inspired, and that inspiration continued here today, especially with the powerful words of Dr. Stallworth. And Pastor, I just want to say it, and I know Dr. Stallworth left, but the word that I typed on my phone was reinstatement, and reinstatement of position. And as I stood and listened to him, and in the words of an inspiration legacy of Dr. King, and our daily obligation as individuals in whatever role, capacity, or position we have, I really thought of our pastors. Him, you, Pastor Mose, all the religious leaders, as the voice of Dr. King's legacy. The powerful voices that God has placed in our city, in our community, in this church. And it means a lot. And so I leave inspired, wanting to do more. And then, of course, to see the scholarships and the impacts. Were those videos powerful or what? And we've participated over time. And then we lost a little bit, so I told Pastor, and I just checked with my office, that we want to make sure we match so that there can be however many more, I think you said 10 students with $1,000 scholarships. That's what we were supposed to do last year. I don't know if we did. So it was five. So we want to do that and continue that going. I remember going back with this scholarship fund years ago, and when you said reinstatement, it meant to me, whether it's in the tradition today, but as I stand here, Russell Temple, and at East End and the churches, the powerful role that you and we continue to play. Appreciate the partnership, the leadership, and the inspiration. Godspeed. All the best. Thanks. Oh, one more thing I got to give Pastor McCullough credit for, and I haven't announced it. The Bridgeport Promise Program is being launched soon. Thank you for your initiation and your support. We'll see that thing happening in Bridgeport. God bless.
Come on, give God some praise. Come on, Pastor Mose, you're going to close us out in prayer. Can we all stand? Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Mayor. He's going to match the scholarships. Amen. So we thank God for that. Chris, amen. We see if we can get that up to 12,000. Hallelujah. Amen. He's going to match it. Amen. And we're going to give $1,000 scholarships out. Amen. To kids this year. Amen. 20 kids, 30 kids. The sky's the limit. Pastor Mose, amen. Come on, close us out in prayer.
If I may be allowed to just say very quickly, I want to thank the IMA. Amen. My daughter attends Spelman College. Amen. We had literally nothing. Amen. And we were sending our daughter to school. Amen. And Pastor McCullough called and said, I know what's going on with the church and the transition. Amen. And he provided my daughter, amen, Simone, with a scholarship. So I want to publicly thank him and the IMA on behalf of my daughter. Yes, that's the bill. So whoever is watching, amen, these are real students. These are real stories. It's making a real impact, amen. And she had a 4-0, amen, because I told her, you got to be right. That's who she heard. There, so she was there and was the president of the freshman class there at Spelman. Amen. So God is faithful, yes. Amen. Let us pray.
Before you close us out, just an announcement, amen. We're planning a Black History prayer breakfast, amen. It used to be an MLK prayer breakfast. COVID came, and so we had to shift some things. So the last Saturday morning in February, amen, the 25th, amen, a prayer breakfast, a scholarship prayer breakfast. It's going to be at the Creative Arts Building over on Logan Street. Amen. Get ready for that. Amen. And support that. That's the way to help with the scholarships also.
Yes, amen. Let us pray. Kind, eternal Father, giver and sustainer of all things, we first come to honor your name, Jesus Christ. We thank you for the gift of Dr. Martin Luther King that you gave to us. Pray now that not just his prayers, amen, not just his dream, not just his history, but Lord, that we finish the assignment. He said that injustice anywhere was a threat to justice everywhere. Help us as we leave this place to be banners of his witness, of his life, and the sacrifice of he and so many other nameless souls and martyrs that died, that marched, that were bitten by dogs, that were fired, that were ostracized. Let their sacrifice become the needed push that we need to give back to our communities, that we continue to serve you, that we become living epistles written and read of all men, that they may see our works and glorify the Father. Be with this administration. Touch our president, touch our vice president, bless our mayor, all of our city leaders, that we may live a peaceable life and you may get the glory in all things. Touch our children in college. Let these funds be used that they may be able to be a blessing. In Jesus' name, amen.